Welcome to Greenable Woodbridge. I'm your host, Carolyn Ehrlich. Throughout the township, people and businesses are doing whatever they can to help us save our environment. And today we are visiting one of our local businesses, Nicholas Markets Foodtown in Colonia, to see what they are doing here. We are now inside the store with the grandson of the owner of Nicholas Markets, and this truly is a family business, as Nick Maniacci, did I get it right?
Yes, you got it right.
Yeah. As Nick is going to share with us. So Nick, tell us the story and the mission of Nicholas Markets.
Yeah, so we started in 1943 with my grandfather's first store. It was a smaller store, kind of like a Krauser's, mini mart. Eventually, built, worked hard, you know, tried to live the American dream, and got our first major store in North Hailden. My father joined the business along with my other two, his other two brothers, and built it to what it is today. We currently have four stores, one here in Colonia. We also have one in Cedar Grove, another one in North Hailden, and our last one is in Washington Township, New Jersey. And that's how, yeah, that's how we got started. That's it.
And what is your mission?
Our mission here is to bring, you know, wholesome, nutritious food every single day, fresh. We like to say that we're the place that foodies like to shop. And our mission also stay green and continue to help the environment.
Which is why you're on this show.
Yeah, it's one of our biggest things here.
Right.
One of the biggest things that, you know, it goes hand in hand with food. Mm-hmm. It really does. And what we're doing. Our mission is to keep it green. It really is. So.
That is great.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're holding a jar. What is this?
Oh, yeah. So this is our Sunny's Honey, Wildwood Honey. We produce this on site. All four stores have four hives. We have something like it's 5 or 10 million bees.
Really?
Yeah, 10 million bees. I think each hive is around 1 million bees per hive.
Oh, my gosh.
It's quite the operation. They're on top of every store.
Uh-huh.
And we harvest. We harvest at the end of summer. Spin it ourselves, and then package it and sell it to you guys.
I understand there's some benefits of having honey that's made locally, health benefits. Can you explain that?
Yeah, some of the benefits they say, I think they're true, is that if you buy local honey, the bees are actually going to the local flowers, and they're taking that pollen. And what that does is that pollen, when you ingest the honey that's from your local area, it supposedly boosts your immune system, because the local flowers and allergens that you face are the ones that you're going to be putting into your body, and that pollen is supposed to buff up your immune system so that you don't react.
That is so interesting.
Yeah, it is,
I never
right?
knew that.
Yeah, it's
that
one of the
fantastic.
Little funky things with honey that's pretty crazy.
That is crazy. Yeah, that really is.
And not only that, the honeybees right now are dying.
Yeah, I heard that.
Everybody knows the extinction, right? So we got to keep those bees alive. Mm-hmm. So if we could do our small part to do it, we try, you know?
That is great. So this is now, who's Sonny?
Sonny is, that's my grandfather's nickname.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so we used to call him Sonny because he always had a smile on his face.
Oh.
Walk in the room and light it up. So we call him Sonny, and it carried through. And yeah, so we decided to do this in the honor of him. Because, you know, such a wholesome product and so good for everybody and helps the community. And that's the type of person that he is.
That
so this
is
really
great.
Embodies what he
That
know,
is great.
Is and was.
And I think another member of your family is represented on this
show. Yeah, so right here we have, this is Anna's, my grandmother's sauce. This is her own special recipe. We bottle it in a separate packing and ship it in. Something we just recently brought in, and we're actually really proud of it. It's going really well. So I'm sure you'll take home a bottle later.
I definitely will,
we'll
but I gotta pay for it.
No, we'll give it to you. See how this goes.
So let's move on now, because another wonderful thing about this store is the pride they take in the produce, and we're going to let Ken, the store manager, talk to us about that. So follow us over to produce. We in the produce section with Ken Burkell. And before we start talking about all this great produce, Ken has a phenomenal philosophy about his relationship with customers. And if you could just take a minute to, I got to just say this because I shop here. He knows almost every customer by name, and he knows that I come in here for the blueberries. So talk a little bit about how much you care about your customers.
Sure, Caroline. First off, welcome to Nicholas Markets Foodtown of Colonia. Welcome to our store. This truly is a community supermarket. It's a small little community, very nice people, very diverse community. But you know what? Customers like Caroline, and the majority of my customers, I come in here, I enjoy them. This is their supermarket, you know, and I'm the director of the store, but I love to greet them. I love to tell them about what's good today, what they have to have, you know. And our philosophy really is, you know, just providing good, healthy product to the community, the freshest as we can be, you know, in a timely manner, you know, at a fair price. You know, the Nicholas Markets prides itself on having fresh product. We source it from all over the world, but certainly during the summer months. I know Caroline, you know, she loves when we get our corn from the Donaldson family, our tomatoes, peppers. We support Jersey farmers almost year round now,
right, yes.
Which is a beautiful thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we're all about local, you know, whether it's our own honey or our produce or our meats or our bakery, anything that we could do to, you know, to procure a product from the state of New Jersey or locally, we're in, you know. And we love telling the story to our customers.
Yes.
You know, I always tell you when the Jersey Blues are in,
right,
or they're coming, make sure you're here, you know. But, you know, the Miniacci family that owns the store is very a proud family that likes to provide great eating experiences, you know. And how do we do that? So we try to get different products from farmers that the bigger stores may not carry.
Right.
You know, I buy ice cream and fresh milk from up in the Adirondack Mountains.
Uh-huh.
You know, and you won't find that everywhere. You know, we taste it. We make sure we would buy it ourselves.
And you stay so thin.
Lean.
As a taster.
Lean. You know, they keep me busy here, so that's how it works.
If you told me my job was to taste ice cream, that would be a real problem.
Absolutely. You know, but really our mission here is to provide a good, warm, welcoming supermarket to the community. You know, we try to stay fresh and clean, you know, and a nice place to shop. You know, it's that simple, Caroline.
Oh, that is great. So, you know, the reason why we came here, not just because it's the local supermarket that I shop at, and I love everybody here and the products and the, you know, the wonderful produce and the local produce, they do something behind those doors that is just extraordinary. They, and Ken has been telling me that, because he knows what I'm interested in with the sustainability, there is no food waste coming out of this store. And I really can't wait to show our viewers how this system works. So please come with me to the back of the store. Okay, we are here in the back of the store with Jamie Wojcik, who works for Grind to Energy, which they have a fascinating process. We all talk about recycling and what we do with waste, and we give ourselves big pats on the back when we get to 50% recycled, and even bigger pats when we get to 75%. Our goal right now in township-wide is hopefully one day to get to 80%. But here, something that we can't even imagine yet, they have made it with their food waste zero. Zero food, zero waste goes to the landfill. That is just incredible. The methane gases that aren't being formed and all the problems that come with waste are gone. And I can't wait to hear how you do that. So Grind to Energy is a company that came up with the process to take care of all of the waste here and do something with it, which we'll find out what that something is, and then turn it into energy. So Jamie, tell us all about it.
So here we are at Nicholas Markets. Basically what we're doing, we're supplying them with the green bin, like you see in the things, a bunch of those. They go to every department, collects all their food waste in those bins. Once they get all the food collected, they'll come out here and bring it to the table. They'll empty it on the table, mix it all up, because it does have a hard time with dry stuff, but all the material together, the wet and dry, put it all together, and then start the system up. And basically what it does is grinds up all the system. Instead of going down the drain like people would have with a garbage disposal at their house, it goes and it's pumped into up the pipe, out the top, and into the outside into a holding tank. There, the holding tank holds the food waste until it's full. We monitor that tank, so when it's once it's full, we call a truck in, a pump truck. We'll pump it, take it all away, and bring it to an anaerobic digester in Ridgewood, New Jersey, where there they'll take it and make renewable energy. They make electricity from it, fertilizer, and also heat. So 100% of the food waste from this store is being reused as renewable energy. Nothing's going to waste.
Wow, that would be great if somehow we could do that with our curbside pickup with the food in Woodbridge. That would just be fantastic. This is the tank. Wow, I live right back there and I never realized this was here. Tell us about it.
Yeah, so this is where all the food waste is pumped out into this tank. It's a 3,000 gallon tank, and it takes about 7 to 10 days before it's filled up, you know, and then it's being pumped out by a pump truck and brought to the anaerobic digester. Here we have a blanket on it and it's insulated for in the winter so it doesn't freeze. It's thermostatically controlled. And we also have a vent on top that's a charcoal vent, so there's no smell.
None whatsoever.
None.
And no noise.
No noise, yeah, quiet. That's
perfect.
It.
Perfect, thank you.
Yep.
Okay, what we have here is, in my store I sell fresh cut fruit. So what we do is we take all the trim, all the waste, something that is not good enough for me to give to you, we cut it up. All this food waste goes into the grind energy, okay? All the rinds of the pineapple, less than spectacular watermelon, that's it. Seafood, deli, anything that's not right goes in the bucket. Same thing with dairy. Any dairy products, all goes into the grind energy. Same as produce, something's not right, it's off.
So there are so many fascinating facts and statistics and stories that go along with food waste to energy. So fill us in a little bit more about what goes on here.
Sure, my pleasure, Caroline. So what happens at store level, all right? So my perishable departments bring in the freshest product, but that product doesn't always stay fresh. And I don't want to sell bad product. So what we do every single day and throughout the day, my department managers and associates will go through the product, such as produce. We're constantly trimming lettuce, grabbing a bad tomato, that apple that fell on the floor. I don't put it back on the stand. And unfortunately, it has to go to the grinder energy. And we're constantly going through all of my perishable departments, okay? My produce, my meat, my dairy, even frozen. You say frozen food. What could waste there? Well, the bag rips. I'm not going to tape it, right?
Yep.
So it has to go somewhere. The deli, the seafood, the bakery. It all goes here. How do we collect it? We go through our departments with these totes that Grind Energy provided for us, and we gather it. What happens after we gather it? We come back. We come back into our back room, and we use our Grind Energy table. So what happens? So we use our table. We're going to show a demo a little later of how that works. All right? And it grinds the product, and it goes out into the silo or out into the tank that we showed you. And it's like a slurry, and it's a liquid, okay? And then that gets gathered. So that carries about 3,000 gallons of this slurry and liquid, okay? And which in turn, what that product, that byproduct, it will actually provide energy to 70 single-family homes, okay?
That's
for
incredible.
For each tank. It sure is. Oh. It really is. So instead of this product going to the landfill and causing problems for the atmosphere with the methane, we're capturing it. We're taking something, we're taking a negative, and we're turning it into a positive.
It's the ultimate win-win.
It is. It really is. You know, and it's the right thing to do, Carolyn.
Yeah.
You know, we have to think about the future generations, you know, our children's children. And this is our little part that we could do to help the environment, you know.
Exactly. So, and that's what I always say. If everybody did their little part, it would be solved.
Absolutely.
There's nothing too little, but this is big.
Yeah.
This is not little.
Yeah. And not only do we do it here at this location, we do it at all of our locations, which is even a bigger win for everybody, you know. It's a great thing. And more throughout the country, you're seeing companies getting on board and understanding the ramifications of what we as humans are doing to our own world.
Right.
You know, and if we could change that, if we could do our little part, then you know what?
In Woodbridge, 25% of our total waste is food waste.
Absolutely.
So that's very, very big. And that's a problem that we're trying to figure out a way to solve. And you have kind of taken the first step to helping us solve that, so thank you.
Well, we're proud to be part of the township, and you know, and the mayor, and you know, your committee, and us as a store. It's a partnership. We're part of this community, you know. And if we could do our part, you know, maybe it'll encourage others to do their part, and then all of a sudden, the bigger picture is a win. So
thank you.
All right.
Now we're going to go outside to see what you, the viewer, can do to help us minimize waste. Let's go. So one of my real pet peeves are the plastic bags. Every time I see people, I say, please don't use the plastic bags. Bring your own bag so that we don't have to have this kind of waste. And I don't know if people realize that it could take a plastic bag 1,000 years to decompose in a landfill. It's just, they're horrible. And when they get into our waterways, they hurt the fish. So we really all should be making an effort to get rid of these plastic bags. I know I have bags that I bring with me every time I come to the supermarket. And I leave here, I look like the bag lady. And you have bags that... And also, if I may add, how much money do you take off of my shopping for bringing those bags?
For every one of these bags, Carolyn, I give you a nickel back.
Right.
You know, And that's our part of trying to encourage people to use the recyclable bag. You know, and you're so right, Carolyn. You know, it's so bad for the environment, the plastic. You know, and it's so simple to carry these. I talk to customers all the time. Often I'll even give them the bag. I said, well, one, it has my name on it, so I always want my name out there.
Right.
You know, but you know, the bags are they're reusable. They'll last for years. They're heavy duty.
Right.
You know, but that's our part. That's our part to eliminate this.
Yes.
We don't want this in the environment. How many times, just as citizens, have we seen these bags blowing around? The litter,
yep.
It's unsightly, it makes our community look bad.
Right.
You know what? If we kept these in our cars and we just use these, it's simple. And I give you a nickel back for each bag.
Exactly.
You know, it's a good thing.
It is great.
And for those people who forget or do want to use the plastic, what is this?
So what happens? We make these available.
So, you know, let me just interrupt you a minute.
Sure.
Because I don't think people realize, because in their garbage, they can recycle plastic. They cannot recycle plastic bags. That does not go into our waste stream. It has to be recycled separately.
Correct.
And that is why they need to bring them here.
Correct. So the company that I buy the plastic bags, unfortunately, that I have to buy them, you know, but picks it up every single week from my store. And they take it back to a processing plant that is designed just for these bags.
All so right. They are getting recycled.
Oh, absolutely. Every single one.
Right.
Yeah.
So for the our viewers, if you do like those plastic bags and insist on using them, don't put them into your recycling. Bring them back here so they can be recycled properly. Or we also have special containers for plastic bags in Town Hall and at Public Works. So thank you.
You're welcome.
This is a big help for the environment.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ken and Nick, for all of the wonderful things that you do to help us save our environment. And thank you, viewers, for watching Greenable Woodbridge and being part of the excitement and part of the change.